Your most accurate forecast from the First Coast News weather team, sponsored by AC Designs.
And folks, in case you don't know Anthony, he will not give up. I suspect we're going to hear more. Let's take a look. Again, if you missed it, just want to let you know that although it's dry out there now, clouds are increasing. And maybe you can't see that now that the sun is setting. There'll be some showers heading in. More showers for those of you over southeastern Georgia, northeastern Florida. For most of us in the Jacks Metro, the few showers out there won't arrive until after 9. And notice the warming just continues. Even at 9 o'clock, temperatures in many areas still sitting near 70 degrees. All week long, we've been talking about the approach of the front. It's been a stormy one, but the portion of the front heading our way is going to weaken and slow down in a big way until what we call a kicker kind of kicks in. Here it is. So Friday, there's the front draped really over the northern portions that we call the First Coast, which is one of the reasons why tomorrow I think we'll have a lot of clouds. There'll be a few showers around, but I'm really not expecting violent weather because this portion of the front will be slowing down and will be so weak. This kicker out around the panhandle, that is of Texas and Oklahoma, will then kick all of this eastward. One of the reasons we use that term. But as it does so, we'll fire up one more round of showers and thunderstorms. But that probably won't start to impact us until after sunset Saturday. And then it's going to push through, I think, by about 1 p.m. on Sunday. So here we go. Here comes the weakening, slowing front. So there'll be some showers around. Notice the winds aren't going to be that strong. Despite all the clouds and still a few showers around, we'll have enough sun to still see temperatures make it up to near 80 degrees. Morning low of 60 to about 65 around the area. Coastal waters looking about like this. Again, watch for the chance of an isolated thunderstorm. For those of you fortunate enough time to have tea time on Friday, here's how it looks for you if you still want to take a swing. Again, I'm talking about some scattered showers, maybe an isolated thunderstorm, so I'm not guaranteeing you a birdie of a day, but if you've already made the plan, certainly nice warm temperatures, greens out there with those temperatures we've had. Here it comes, I think, if you've been working or going to school all week long. There'll be a little fog during the morning. Again, I'm thinking now the showers with the next front will hold off until after sunset, so spring break fever is my diagnosis for Saturday. Temperatures going up to 82, but there'll be some spots away from the beaches in which we might even see some middle 80s out there. Now, Sunday morning, going to services, there will be some showers around, but I think those showers will be out of here by 1 p.m. on Sunday. So Sunday afternoon, cooler, but bluer skies blowing in, and we'll still see temperatures of about 70. Now, of course, all week long, we've been talking about the approach of the cold front. So although it is going to technically be colder, seasonably so. I'm really headlining this because nothing like the cold event we had over a week ago. In fact, if you're new to the area or if you've forgotten, this time of the year, a seasonable cold front will drop temperatures down to about 40. We'll have afternoon highs of about 60 to 64, and that's what we're going to have. And if one of the reasons maybe you don't necessarily like the warm weather is because we just don't see those clear blue skies, well, those polar blue skies will blow back in by Monday.
That's looking good, Tim.